In the bicentennial year, 1976, the Packers acquire Houston Oilers backup quarterback and promising talent, Lynn Dickey.
I wanted to go to Denver, and Denver had no interest in me at all.
Lynn was the real deal, and man, he could throw that ball.
There was a car parked right in front of my house, and I'm thinking, I wonder who that is out there. So finally, I went out and just rapped on the window.
Still the most accurate long thrower, deep thrower I've ever seen.
He rolls the window down, of course, smoke comes rolling out. And it's a man named Lou Carpenter. And Lou Carpenter had been our receiver coach in Houston for a couple of years. I said, Lou, what are you doing out here?
He was a major, major part of the solution.
He goes, I want to know if you want to come up and play for the Pack. I said, Green Bay. He goes, yeah, we got a good young team brewing. You know, we need some younger quarterback in there. I said, doesn't it get really cold up there?
He gave us hope.
In 1977, in a game that was already long lost to the Rams, quarterback Lynn Dickey sustains a double fracture to his left leg and is lost to the game of football for nearly 2 years. Down 23-0 at halftime, the Packers rallied for the biggest comeback in team history, a record held until 2013. Quarterback Lynn Dickey passes for 237 yards and 3 second-half touchdowns.
The best quarterback that I played with was Lynn Dickey. He was just special.
Lynn Dickey does not get the credit he deserves because he was a quarterback of very good offenses, but not ultra-successful teams.
Lynn was not going to be bouncing around the pocket, and that was just a fact of life.
The ultimate field general, he knows where everybody's supposed to be. He reads the defense like there's no tomorrow. He throws a pretty ball.
If we got criticized because we gave up a lot of sacks, so what? That was just the price you paid for having that quarterback that could spin a mean ball.
There's a fine line between mental toughness and stupidity. I was in there somewhere. I don't know exactly where I fit in.
Lynn Dickey held the single season record for the most yards passed for in team history when people didn't throw the ball a lot.
I'd come in on Wednesday morning and get the game plan for that week, and I'd look and there's like 10 new passes, no runs, but we never tried to run the ball that much.
I told one guy, I said, look here, I said, Lynn Dickey can throw a football through an eye of a moving needle.
Lynn Dickey put me, Paul Coffman, and John Jefferson in the Pro Bowl.
With Lynn Dickey as a quarterback, and with Lofton and John Jefferson, Paul Coffman, they were fun to watch.
We were pretty good. If you take one side of the football before the year starts and go, okay, this group's going to be in the top five, well, I'll take that.
They were extremely entertaining football team.